Good morning, November the 27, 2014. This is CISG 113, Section 1, Information Security and Privacy. Today, we have two teams who would like to do the in-class forum, taking up exactly 1 hour, and then we have the class official evaluation scheduled at 11. So let's get started. Welcome back, and because of the technical problem with the screen, it cannot come down, so you have to bear with this screen for a while, and if you have video to show, maybe you can just adjust the screen. So, without much ado, may I invite team number two, are you ready to come up here, take out the computer, lock me out and lock you in? Today, instead of the chocolates, we do have chocolate chips, also from San Francisco. All right, hopefully, because of that, more students can join the discussions. And after team number two, it's team number. Yes, they are the first, right? And then it's your team, right? Yeah, it's okay. It's you're the first. Can I pass the microphone to you?
Make the best use of the two microphones.
All right, because this team signed up on last week, so they're the first, and then we'll follow this with the sign up of this week, okay? And hope you're getting ready for the discussion.
So today we will have a discussion, and our topic is information technology. So let me show you what is information technology. Information technology is the application of computers and telecommunications equipment to store, retrieve, transmit, and manipulate data, often in the context of a business or other enterprise. And the term is commonly used as a synonym from computers and computer networks, but it also includes other information technology such as television and telephone. And several industries are related with information technology, including computer hardware, software, and electronics, and semiconductors, internet, telecom equipment, e-commerce, and computer service.
Information technology presents convenient instant information, instant communication, exchange message, and can effectively organize files. Second, reduce errors, improve applications. And last, improve people's life. For example, computer control, home appliance, smartphone protect. Information technology shortcomings. First, delayed technology. Two, need lots of computer crimes appear. For example, computer virus and hacker defrauded data. We reduce the communication between people. And the last is protect loss of society problem. For example, when these parents information at the cloud issue.
Okay, let us just see the video first. Information technology, IT. It's this, this, and this. IT is wow. It's stuff your parents haven't even thought of yet. IT is moving, it's mixing, sharing, and more. IT is solving problems, thinking, and processing. IT is making money, saving lives, changing the world. It's a living, it's a life. IT is in your pocket. It's at your fingertips. It's here, there, and everywhere. IT is on CSI. In business, in the lab, it's in the hospital, on the radio, in the movies. IT is behind eBay, iTunes, and Facebook. IT is people who make it work, who figure it out, make it happen. That's it. That's IT. Information technology. Talk to your school counselor. Take the classes. You're it? This video is talk about what is information technology. And we play the second video. Okay. Let's take a discussion. And the first question is, do you think information technology is important to us? Why? I give you 5 minutes to discussion.
Yes, you need to position 2 microphones, one on each side, and start gathering the feedback of your fellow students. The question is, do you think IT is important?
Yes, I think IT is important to us because we can use
as you can see, we are using projector to deliver message in our class, and we have different, such as UN Blue environment that also connect to IT. I think that's why this is very important.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Over there.
IT is very convenient for us to search for many information, and it can help us to save a lot of time.
Yes, continue.
Do you have any idea?
I have a suggestion. For those of you who are willing to share, you can use that as one instance of your in-class participation. That is going to be very good for you. I hope this could help. Over there. And you need to give your name, okay?
Beatrice. And I think that information technology really helps us because we can search many information online, and through the internet, we are very easy, and we can quickly find out what we want.
Very good. Now, please make sure you remember this instant and put it in your record, all right? You should have many more participations now. Just keep going. Repeat your question.
The question is, do you think information technology is important to us, and why?
Okay? You have already got quite a number of suggestions, feedback from your fellow students. Now watch your time, okay?
Okay, let us to answer our team ideas. Our team frame idea is very important for us because I did improve in serving complex problem at a really small time, and it might train our style also.
Okay, the second question. Not yet,
we,
right?
We play the second video.
Okay.
Thank you.
this video, we can see more information about the relationship, about the information technology. So let's go to the second question.
Yes, please read out the second question.
And the second question is, what is the application of the information technology? And I give you about 3 minutes to discuss that.
Now remember, those of you who joined the discussions, you can use that as one of the important records of your in-class participation score. So you very much need them if you do not have enough. You have microphone, you need to go one on each side, microphone, to pass the microphone to your fellow students.
Have anyone here to ask our team question?
Yes, you can ask them question too. What's the applications of the information technology?
Jessica, I think many companies use it to manage their company, their workers as well.
Okay, thank you for your answer. Anyone here?
We can add software, method, and other is okay.
So I think the most information application we use is, I think it's WeChat here. So we need to check with friends like Facebook or everything we use is called information technology, right?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you for your answer. Maybe our team thinks that IT can use in the education area. If before teacher to teach something, maybe why on the blackboard, but now they can use computer or projector to show their thinking to teach us.
The information technology can improve our students and promote the cultural exchange, such as the network can transport the message and money fast quickly. And NIF cannot without information therapy because we are living in the information age. Although the information therapy have a lot of advantage, we can't over rely it because we must think about the find such as the information for and the crime.
Okay, thank you team number two for helping us to understand your topic. So it's very good, you're making the best use of your time. Have you finished?
Yes.
Thank you. So the next team, it's Cindy's team, right? All right. We're getting more teams who would like to do the in-class forum. Now, you still have two chances next Monday and Thursday. Are you ready? Okay.
Good morning, everybody. We are Team One, and I'm Cindy.
I'm Jessica.
I'm Amy.
And Charlie is sick, and she didn't come to the class. First, our topic is decryption, and let me tell you what is decryption first. Decryption is a practice that can change the text to be a chain of code, and the others cannot see your text while they did not have the password. And decryption is used for protection and authentication. Here we list three types of encryption. There is hashing and symmetric methods and asymmetric methods. And hashing is with a Unicode fixed length signature for a message or data set. Each hash is Unicode to a specific message. So minor change to that message would be easy to track. And symmetric method is encryption is also known as private key cryptography, and is called so because the key used to encrypt and decrypt the message must remain secure, because anyone with access to it can decrypt the data. And asymmetric methods, asymmetric encryption or private key cryptography is different than the previous method because it's used two keys for encryption or decryption. Now we show a video of you.
Whether it's chip chat or about very sensitive information about our jobs, most of us depend on the internet while we communicate. Unfortunately, there might be other individuals with malicious intentions who also want to reach this information, which is only supposed to be shared between you and the receiver of this message. So how can we know if this information reaches the receiver without being copied or stolen? Kate wants to send her friend John this message, but she's scared that someone can catch this message and scrape the John and get a hold of this information. First, Kate locks her message with a key which only she has the copy of. So when she sends this to John, no one that Kate doesn't want can reach this message. There is one problem though. Since John doesn't have the key to the lock, it is impossible for him to reach the message and decrypt the code. So Kate needs to send the key to John via internet again, so that John can see the message. This type of encryption is called symmetric encryption. But be careful, it has several problems to it. The message could be stolen by the person, and it could easily be opened by also stealing the key. For a long time, it was thought that this problem of key exchange was impossible to solve, until some people came up with a new type of encryption, asymmetric encryption. So this is how it works. Kate locks the message with her public key and sends this to John via internet. Then when John receives this message, which is locked with Kate's public key, he also locks this message with his public key and sends the message back to Kate. Now Kate can open the message with her private key and send it back to John. And lastly, John receives the message with his own public key on it. He decodes the message with his private key and he is not able to understand it. So the message never crossed the internet without a lock, and no one except Kate and John accessed the message. Ta-da! Problem solved. But wait, so what if Kate's mother-in-law pretends to be John while she puts her own public key and sends the message back to Kate for her to remove the public key? Then what happened? Thank you for watching this presentation about private and public key encryption.
So in the meantime, you actually have to, thank you very much, the screen is coming back, thank you. You have to take the two microphones and go around to collect the feedback from your fellow students. Now remember, if you join the discussions here in response to your fellow student groups in class forum, you can take this as one incident of your in-class participation, and that is very worthwhile. Because you need those records to earn your in-class participation score. So maybe you can just take the microphones around, yeah, one on each side. Over there. Here. Keep your name.
I'm Stephen, and in my opinion, I will set the password in my phone and computer, and that's all.
Thank you. You need two microphones, you're two persons, you can have one on each side, okay? Don't let letter one so difficult, all right?
I think encryption can be applied when we send the email.
Okay, over there.
Hello, I'm Jenny. I think one example is when you hold a
thank you. Over there, it's Iris.
Iris, I think the government should be the one who use the encryption the most, because the country's data, they have to put the encryption to protect the information in the country.
Thank you. Now, besides listening to your fellow students' feedback, one of the important jobs that you have to do is to repeat the feedback to the whole class, and then maybe you want to follow up with some question, you can do it, okay? So you are in charge.
Everybody.
actually, to defend identity theft, we all should have the encryption. Encryption can keep our data safe only if you keep your password secret. And nowadays, a big business uses to protect corporate secrets. Government uses to secure classified information. And many individuals use it to protect personal information to guard against things like identity theft.
And the second discussion question is, have you encrypted your file? Why or why not?
Yes, maybe something important information I will encrypt it. Yes, thank you.
Over there?
Yes. I do not encrypt my file, but I encrypt my computer because I think that if I set a password in my computer, it's safe enough.
Okay.
I'm Fish. Yes, I encrypt my file because I want to protect my privacy.
I'm Stephen, and I will encrypt my iPhone because my friend always see my phone and reach my picture and send my picture to his phone.
Okay. That is funny. Okay. Over there.
I'm Winnie. I will protect my file. I will set the password of this because I don't want someone to see my pictures or documents, something like that.
Alright.
This is CN. I have tried to encrypt my file like Word. The reason why I encrypt the word because I want to see how it works, but yeah, just want to try the experience.
Thank you.
I'm Lisa, and I haven't equipped my phone, and the reason why I don't equip it is that I lock my computer in my own room.
Okay.
You can encrypt your computer and it can defend hackers to hack in
or too many passwords in my computer.
Is there any opinion?
Amelia. For me, I just encrypt some important files just like my diary, but I don't ask because I set a password for my computer. I think that's normally this is safe.
Over there, one more, yes.
America, and I have set a password in my smartphone, but I don't think it's safe enough because all my friends know my password and they can still use my phone.
Okay.
You can think about what is the benefits of encryption.
The first benefit is that we can protect our file, and the second, I think maybe some company can develop a encryption system and they can earn money.
Thank you.
And I think that the most important is to protect our own privacy.
Yes.
Amelia, I think that is not only benefits, but some they will make us confused because we send too many passwords.
That's true.
encryption key service prevent service provider from accessing data. That's why the others cannot see your data if they don't have the keys. And encryption house meeting regulation. And now I will show you encryption can encrypt our email documents or our file. And now I will show you how to encryption to our USB.
Welcome to 24H Computer Repair. Today's topic is how to encrypt USB drive. Go to the website www.trueencrypt.org and then the download section and download the new version of TrueCrypt. Now, we will install the software. When the installation is finished, we'll start the software and insert the USB drive that we want to encrypt. We click on Create Volume, select Encrypt Non-System Partition Drive, and click on Next. We select Standard TrueCrypt Volume and click on Next. We click on Select Drive and choose our USB drive on the list. Then we click on OK and then Next. Again, Next, and two more times Next. Now, we type the password that we want and confirm it, and then click Next. We move the mouse for 10 to 15 seconds randomly inside the window and click on Format. When the format is done, it is necessary to mount our USB drive so we're able to use it. We start the TrueCrypt, choose an available volume, and click on Auto Mount Devices. Type the password and the USB drive is ready to use. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to our channel and comment what would you...
This is the way to encrypt our USB, but it looks is a little bit difficult, but it can protect our data while we lost our USB.
To conclude, encryption is a good way to have information security as it can perfectly protect our personal data. Although it may not be convenient, it is still necessary for us to do as nowadays computer crime is running wildly. At last, you should show your family and friends of how to do the encryption, as this is a protection to all the people who are using the computer, and this is one of the ways to disturbing the crackers. That's all. Thank you for your listening.
Thank you very much. I think you all did a very good work selecting a topic, preparing the PowerPoint, selecting the videos, getting ready the questions, and get your fellow students involved. I discovered that if I encourage you to do a little bit more on responding, that will be wonderful. Okay, thank you very much. I'm finished with the chocolate chips. Okay, anyone who has not got one? Okay, so I love to hear more of this kind of in-class forum because that could give me a little bit more confidence and encouragement that you really know how to pick the resources and use it for the benefits of your fellow students. And you have two more chances to do it next Monday and next Thursday. And next week, we could have three sections per class of all together six times. That means six teams could join. Or better say, six individuals could join or six pairs could join. So make the best use of next Monday and next Thursday. And remember, not just the team who's going to do the in-class forum will benefit. Those of you who are participating in the responses, you can use that as a record of your in-class participation. That will be a great time for you to make up for your losses in the previous part of the semester. So keep a best record of your in-class participation and make sure you indicate what you did. We may say, I respond to foreign question,
during team or six in class forum, and the theme is encryption or something like this, all right? So it's very important for you to grab the very last chance. And fortunately, we have one makeup week, two classes for you to do that. And officially, today is the last class, okay? And that's why I was told that at 11 o'clock today, they're going to do the course evaluation, so about 10 minutes. So now, may I take attendance for today, all right? Very encouraging for me. So maybe this works, but my students in next class love this too, okay? All right. Okay, have a picture. Oh, sorry, I didn't make sure you can see that. All right, picture. Thank you. And, am I in the right? Let's see. No, sorry. I'm sorry. I got into the wrong course. This is for the next class. All right, so, because I lock out and lock in again, so sometimes I got a little bit confused. All right, Halia, thank you. Prolia, yes. Ada, thank you. Ryan Vaughn, thank you. Jenny, thank you. And then Jackie, thank you. Hawk White, thank you. Seahorn, thank you. My phone is not here. Richards now. Huyan, yes, right. Fish, right. And then it's Angela, thank you. Erica, thank you. Ruby is not here today. C, yes. Lisa, thank you. And then it's Locka, thank you. Steven, thank you. Terrence, thank you. Winnie Ernd, thank you. Tom, thank you. Dixon, thank you. Winnie Ho. Thank you. Gideon, thank you. Friend, thank you. Michelle, thank you. Annie, thank you. Cindy, thank you. Neil, Kake is not here today, okay? Oh, sorry. And then Ryan, yes. Lester is not here today, okay. Kelvin, right, thank you. Gao Yan, thank you. Hanson is here, thank you very much. Jessica, thank you. And Tikin, thank you. Charlie is not here today. He's sick, right? Iris is here, all right, thank you very much. So, any specific questions on your learning portfolio? Remember, it must be done on top of the wiki, okay, which is given you studying from week number 11. What you need to do is the simple technique in the wiki to put the name of the link and of the page inside two pairs of square brackets. That's it. Everybody should know how to do it at this point. Yes, Elizabeth. Oh, yes, it's okay. Let me show you one more time. Everybody knows how to do it now. Now, let me just go to your wiki and just show you how to do it. So, this is the wiki space. All right, and say, I go to Elisa's. Elisa, okay. So, here we go, we create a page, all right. So, somewhere here, you can see this is the first page, right? So now, suppose I want to add a PowerPoint. Let me do it at the very end, okay? And you can change it. So this is my PowerPoint for 2014, November the 37. So if this is the name of the file, okay, what you need to do is you need to highlight them, okay? So highlight this file. Now there are two specific ways to do it, because what you need to do is connect this name to the name of a file in your computer. The first thing is to go to this link, okay? When you come to this link, do you see that if you have a direct URL, you can put URL here, but you need to go to your computer. So come here to look at this box. Click on this box, then you are given the browse button, and you know how to do it, right? Once you got everything, you say upload this file, and you're set. But remember, at the end of that, you need to save. If you don't save, you cannot connect with your PowerPoint. Not just for the PowerPoint, your Microsoft Word, your video file, whatever it is. Okay? You got it? All right. That's very good. Now, I'm not saving anything, so you will not see that. All right? So you can try doing that immediately for yourself. That's very good. Excellent question. And one more thing. If you need to record your PowerPoint with your voice, what do? You use the software, okay? You go to screencast.com or you go to week number 8. Over there, the Camtasia software, you install it, and you just run the software, you press the record button. Or if you want to do something even without this software, with your talking, what do? You go to YouTube. Okay, you go to YouTube, and suppose you have a YouTube account, okay? So when you press the, when you press something like the upload button, okay? All right, sorry. I hate to see this, but anyway, my computer does not respond fast enough. You go to read the upload button, press this upload button, okay? Suppose you have a YouTube account. And what do you see next? You see that on the right-hand side, a number of very interesting tools for you. One is called Create a Photo Slideshow, even with your voice. And you can actually press this, and if you have a camera in your computer now, like me, all right? And then you can say, start recording. Let me see if my camera is working, all right? Okay, start recording. And you see that I allow this. So you can see my face here. You can do something similar. And you can start recording. Now it's recording. So at the end of your recording, you say stop. And then they will ask you where to do this. You just simply say, I want to upload them. Okay? Now it's still processing here. Okay? So you may want to say, I want to upload them. And this will be uploaded as a part of the video here. Okay? And then you just type some what we call the descriptions. It takes about 5 minutes of time. Okay, and then when you press publish, your video will be published on your channel. Yes. Wait for about 2 minutes. Okay, so we'll publish in your channel and you can watch it. But of course, you need to set it to public, or you need to set it to private, and then you can attach a video in your learning portfolio. This is something everybody will do today, but of course you have a better background or whatever it is. So it will be very great, but it takes a while, okay? So these will be the basic, nothing more than that in this class. The rest is reading, writing a journal. Remember the importance of OIA in presenting your journal in the Learn-to-Learn score. And then remember, you must put the learn-to-learn activity in your learning portfolio to earn the 15 points. You must put the in-class participation record in your learning portfolio to earn the 20%. And you must put the record of the in-class bonus forum in your learning portfolio to earn the 10%. Remember that. Very important. Now I'm going to pass the time to the lady outside. She's going to do the course evaluations for me. And I will not be back, okay, until 11:30 for the next class. And enjoy the biscuit. All right. Thank you very much. Okay. That's it for this class, CISG 113, Section 1, Information Security and Privacy. on November the 27th, 2014. Today is day number 28.